Hi all, in this video let's learn about jam. This is a bug reporting tool, so you need to understand why we need to learn as a front-end developers why we need to understand about this jam reporting tool. The reason behind this is, see, whatever the application, whatever the environment is, if any issue occurs, okay, everyone points to the front-end, because the data might be missing, the images might be missing, something might go wrong at the front. Okay, only front end part would be visible to everyone. So that's the reason, whatever might be the issue, even if it is the back end issue also, the front end guys would be pointed most of the time. This would be happen. So we need to understand this tool because it helps us to reduce the debugging time. Okay, so few of the errors we'll be getting in the upper environments like AWS or cloud, any of the cloud environments we'll be getting. We'll not get these issues in the lower environments like dev, staging, and pre-prod. These environments, we may not get the issues. But some issues we'll be facing in the cloud, the prod environments. Whenever we get some prod environment issues, okay, like in the upper environments, so QA will be reporting as a bug, but we were unable to reproduce that. Okay, that would be the common fight or common misunderstanding, common things, or this is a common thing. Usually it happens where front end developers used to take more debugging time. Okay, why I'm using this tool and why I'm trying to recommend this is this helped me a lot in one of the problem solving. It helped me a lot. So that's the reason I'm trying to suggest you this tool. So let me explain you how it will help us. So as a front-end developers, when we get any error, what's the main thing we are going to do? So a console tab and the network tab. These are the two tabs which helps us to debug the things. Okay, the console tab, the JavaScript or React or any of the web application, console tab in the developer tools, the console tab is a tab which helps us, which logs the errors. That is the tab. Okay, with this tab you can understand what is the error. Okay, whatever may be the environment, okay, you can easily understand what is the issue with the console tab. And with the network tab, you can understand what is the issue. Okay, like whether you are sending all the API calls or not, if any of the API call was failed or not, this a QA people or an end user can't do it. Okay, majority of these things a QA user or an end user can't do. So you can suggest these tools to the QA and to the end users who is only facing these issues. Okay, that might be respective to the system or resolution or a specific browser. So many things would be there. Okay, they may not understand what exactly we need to debug the things. So that's the reason this tool helps us a lot in these terms. Okay, I will explain you how. So this is like a normal application. This is an open source application I have taken. Like jam, firstly, you need to install this jam. This is a web. You can go to the Chrome extensions and you can install this jam. Okay, it will ask you to log in with your login details. You can log in it. So once it was added to your Chrome, okay, you can see an icon at the top like this. Okay, this is the icon you can see. Okay, fine. Once you see this icon, okay, let me show how it works. So I'm clicking this icon. You can take a screenshot. So if you get any error, so you hear instances like it may be a QA, it may be an end user, it may be your manager. So sometimes some issues would be reported by the managers. Okay, there what exactly you need is console tab and the network tab. This helps you a lot in reducing the debugging time. So I'm clicking on the take a screenshot. So here there is no error. So just I'm taking some screenshot, random screenshot. Here my intention is, so just showcase an issue. So just I'm adding a comment. So you can play around this. So where exactly you are seeing some issue. Okay, the image is missing, the image is blur. You can point this and you can write your comments. You can use this text area, everything here. Fine. So if you click here, create, it will create you a jam link. Okay, you have logged into your jam, right? Through while you're installing the jam and into your Chrome web store, you have logged in, right? It will create you a jam. Okay, it means like a link. This is a link. So where you can copy this link and you can keep into the Jira, or you can send to the respective person who needs to debug this issue. Okay, the interesting part is like it comes here. So the info. So which system, what is the URL? So that you no need to ask them which URL you are getting this error, whether it is a pre-prod, staging, dev, or a cloud environment. Which environment, you no need to ask, because the information is clear. Which device, what is the browser version, what is the resolution, everything was clear. The basic information related to the browser part is clear. They no need to mention, you no need to ask, the information is clear. This is the basic information you need, and you have a console tab. So what happened when during this time, all those errors would be available in the console part. Of course, there is no error at this point, but if there is any error, it would be recorded here. And also the network tab, if there is any errors occurred at this point related to the request and the response failure things, it would be recorded so that you can clearly understand, yes, this API call is failing. This is giving me 504 error. It means some service issue. It is not related to the frontend issue. You can clearly state that. You can go back to the backend people and you can say that this service is not working. So in these ways, you can, it will really help you. It will really save your time because of getting the basic information from the manager, QA, or end user, with getting the basic error block, with getting the basic network tabs. These are the basic information in any of the errors you need at a basic level. Okay, you need. So, and you can share this in the Jira or wherever you want. Directly you can share to them also, it will work. Okay, in this way you can clearly explain what is the error, so that how it helps to the front end guys is, the first phase of debugging would be easier. You can directly go to that point. You no need to reproduce this issue in any of the environments. You no need to understand what is the error, console tabs, log tabs. You no need to ask them if there is any restricted environment. Usually this happens. So when I'm working, so that environment is a restricted environment where I can't access that environment. But I need the basic information. You are getting the point, right? I need the basic information. What is the environment, like device, browser specific? Because to debug something, we need to have some basic information. And I need to have some console logs and network tab. If the environment is not accessible and I need to debug the issue, where the issue is very specific to that environment. In these cases, this will really help you. And this is the case it helped me. So that's the reason I'm trying to explain this as a video. Apart from this, you have a few more options. So let me go here. You have a few more options, like you can record this tab. So if you record this tab, so whatever happened during, so record would be started. Okay, once the recording is started, so some issues, you need to reproduce them. Okay, to reproduce, you need to do a couple of steps, like you need to go to about, or you need to go to the home page, you need to book, you need to book a ride, you need to give some wrong values, right values, you need to search for the things. So you need to do a couple of steps here. So in these steps, you need some consoles, some network tabs. So I'm stopping this. Okay, if you want to record these type of things, okay, recorded to reproduce the issue. Okay, so usually to reproduce the issues, it may take time for the developers. We usually connect to the QA team and we sit more time to understand how they are reproducing. So instead of that, if you record something like this, so usual recording can be done anywhere, but recording with the console tab and the network tab is a very important for us as a front-end developers, because with that you can easily see whatever you save, that would be created a unique link. Okay, and it would be stored in your JAM dashboard. Okay, everything you're doing, that would be saved in a JAM, in your dashboard. It would be saved there, and you can share this link to the respective person. You can keep this in the Jira bug as well. So here you can see whatever happened during our recording. It would be logging the network, the console, the info. So this is the basic information we need. Okay, hope this will clear our most of the issues. It will help us in reducing the time for the debugging. So try to implement it if you like it. Okay, and please subscribe and watch the videos. Thanks for watching. Thank you.